It's not doing anything. Oh, what is his idea? Is he gonna play h5? Is he gonna play rook c8? If he's going to play rook c8, I think I will need a nice centralized piece. Also, I'm attacking a7. It's maybe a little bit annoying. But no, he could just play rook a8 and win a2. So it's not a real attacking, actually. Even if he move his rook to c8. My idea is to go d4 and maybe g7. So this is what I'm gonna do. Also king f6. Okay. Now h4. Oh, there is e5. So annoying. So first f4, then h4. I think that's a nice idea. I can go rook b6, trying to stop any developing. Why not? Okay, let's stop the b5 push. I'm not in a hurry for this move, I think. Actually, I was maybe. Rook g8 will be protecting it. If he goes rook g8, probably bishop h5 is doing anything. Bishop h5. I'm gonna do this move, so at least he cannot move the king now. And okay, how can I improve more? I don't know. Bishop e5 looks nice. So still this will be not moved also. How can I improve? I need my king where? On d4 maybe? But it's tricky to go because he has bishop b5. Oh, let's win some time on the clock. Oh, that was silly move. His idea is rook d7 anyway. Oh man, that was so silly. Okay, now bishop b5 and my rook looks really silly. But maybe no, maybe I have rook d6. Maybe I need my king on b3 so I can push a4. Let's go h4. Okay, move the defender. Can I do this and go h5? And go h5. That looks interesting for g7. Also, maybe then e6 is gonna be falling down. I'm dominating the position, it's pretty nice. I can also take here. And Take on b7. Looks drawish, but I should have some advantage. A g file and also h pawn. Should I move king here? Trying to stop it. There's also this rook here coming and cutting my king. Maybe just f3, king here. Or rook here, rook here. I need 3 moves to do this. So let's go on e2. Or on d2. Let's go here. So rook g8, rook b1, okay. Let's go here. Bishop c6. Can I just do this? I don't know. King d3. Can I go king d3? I think it's okay. I don't know. I feel it like my king can centralize and it's actually mate if I go to c4. So let's go a4. Why I'm feeling I'm gonna lose this game? Did I let this pawn to go too far away? Maybe I should bring the king there. A silly decision. Again, 1 minute against 4, like the previous game. Can I go bishop f6, rook d7? Okay, I need to do this. Bishop f1 is nice move, cutting my okay, let's just take and go here. So can I win now? 34 seconds. Maybe trying to mate mating net. If I could take e6 pawn, so we probably win. 24 seconds. If I take here, it's probably also winning. Or at least I would have a draw. Cannot save both of the pawns. So king here. Eighteen seconds. Let's go f5. And maybe go bishop a3 pre-move. Next move is e4. Your seconds. Six. Three seconds. I'm gonna pre-move this one. Is he gonna take it? Yes, unfortunately. Another guy who played good against me. I don't know how they do it. Okay, here b4, d4 is giving. I think also e4. Queen f4, the best move. I should go queen d6. I don't know, after castling, I didn't like it. h3. Very complicated position, and yeah. This is the position I had the best advantage. I could go rook b5 here. If he takes rook g7. Oh my god. c8. Oh man, this was crazy. And notice this sacrifice here. A4 was a mistake. I should go. Yeah. It was equal position. I don't know, I'm not playing well. Again, queen d6 giving quite the best. But it's very complicated here, I don't know. I'm not understanding this position well. That's why I should go e4. Even if having disadvantage, I know the ideas.